Hello world, my name is Ashish and I'm back with another video on AWS security best practices. Today's topic is AWS Security Hub. You may not have heard about this service just because the service only got into preview mode for all regions in November 2018 and it is still in preview mode. Before we go into the video, just click on the subscribe button and the bell icon so you get notified when a new video comes out from me on AWS security best practices. As always, I've got a Medium article in the description. So if you want to go into a bit more details about where would you use it, why would you use it, what are the use cases for it, you'll find all that over there. And if you want me to cover anything else about the service, I would be happy to create another video for that. So cool, getting into the video now. AWS Security Hub is a new service, which is a new security service from AWS, and it's a central dashboard for insights into malicious behavior on AWS accounts that you own. And also it's a compliance dashboard to keep an eye on whether you're complying with CIS standards to begin with. And I think they're adding more, but for the moment, the only compliance standards that's available at the moment is CIS, which is the Center of Internet Security. Okay, AWS Security Hub best practices. Very first one, enable AWS Security Hub in all regions, enable it in all your accounts, and always use the master child account structure that you have. If you remember from the AWS organizations, if you have used them, it's essentially like a hierarchy. You can have a master account where you start off with the insights, you enable Security Hub, and you enroll all your child accounts into the master account. That's a great way to have a central place and effectively utilizing the service that is AWS Security Hub. As mentioned earlier, you can get compliance dashboards from AWS Security Hub, so it is possible for you to have an insight into the compliance level in all your AWS accounts, so I would triage them. You would find some of the insights produced on AWS Security Hub are not, worth investigating, but it's still worthwhile looking at all the AWS Security Hub that you find. AWS Security Hub has compliance standards for CIS at the moment, which means if you have included or invited and enrolled all your child accounts into the master account, you would be able to check the compliance standards on all your accounts from one spot. From my experience so far, I found that some of the insights, and probably also because it's a learning algorithm, most of the insights were useful, some of them were not. Like for example, I had one where it was talking about, I'm trying to work with Amplify at the moment, AWS Amplify. It's a great service, try it out. And it basically notified that an admin role is trying to perform an action, which is admin, that's the whole point of an admin role. So I think it got a bit confused in my opinion in that one. And unfortunately there is no ignore feature, so I can't ignore it. I just have to archive it. So even though it's a good practice to investigate all security incidents being raised on AWS Security Hub, I would still say triage it first and investigate and find out if it's worth taking it to the next level. Now by next level, I mean use the insights that are produced in AWS Security Hub to create workflows within your organization, where it could be a DevOps workflow or a security workflow or a SOC workflow for identifying and triaging the next possible steps for an incident that has been raised. Guard duty has been really good. So because that's fed into AWS Security Hub already subscribed, so most of those notifications would definitely be something that requires investigation. There are third-party trusted partners as well included as subscription. Now, these third-party subscriptions, you don't have to really subscribe to them, but if you say, for example, have a service existing with Palo Alto or Trend Micro or one of the other providers, I think Twistlock is there as well if you're into container security. These partners are providing a subscription for a small fee. I'm sure if you're already subscribed to them, you can get a deal with them and that should be all right. Trusted partner also brings into the picture from a security standpoint, the resource access policies for what trusted partners are you allowing subscriptions to. It's trusted that the trusted partner are trusted by AWS, but not necessarily by you. So you don't really want another shadow IT subscription in your AWS environment. So I'll probably keep an eye on that. One final thing I'll probably leave that with is the IAM service role, which is used by AWS Security Hub. You probably don't want to give it too many permissions apart from the ones that require. If you look at the default IAM service role which is created, it doesn't really have much to begin with, but it does give you an option to select an existing IAM role. I would probably say stick to the one that they provide, which already has the least permission possible for that IAM role that they need. That's pretty much what I had about the AWS Security Hub best practices. I've got another video on how do you use AWS Security Hub, getting started with it. So check for that link in that YouTube channel. And there is a Medium article which is talking about the use cases, where do you want to use it, why do you want to use it, and the cost associated with it. So do check that out. A link is in the description. And do like the video if you like the video. And leave a comment if you want me to cover anything else on the topic. And I would be happy to create another video. Until then, peace out.